If you want a very straight to the point answer, then if you're in the market for this LP, then this is the pressing you want. It absolutely does justice to the music. All right, today we have a really good one. As you can see, this is Alexis On Fire's debut self-titled album, originally released in 2002. This is the repress from 2021, however. I'm sure I'm not the only one who has experienced a very long wait hoping for a repress. And the day that a repress came for this, it was a very good day. For those unaware, there are about three different versions of this. And there is the original, which came from 2002, and that's quite rare to find. And when you would find it, it would be priced out of my budget. Represses have followed in 2014 and 2017, but these have a problem which is unacceptable to me. These pressings use what they refer to as a remaster. However, they are more than a remaster, as a remaster just indicates that there is differences in the finishing loudness, whereas with these pressings, they go further than that in actually cutting versions of the songs, such as the piano outro in Adela Is Missing. What were they thinking? How did they get away with this? Who is responsible? Send them to hell. Okay, it's not that bad, but still, my point remains. And also, it just doesn't sound as good. They've done a botched job of it, in my opinion. It's important to note that I had tested two versions of the same pressing of this. Around the edges, one of them did have a chip in it, which had me concerned for the quality control. But when I actually listened to the records back to back, they were both very consistent with each other. So that's a relief. And it could have just been a one-off. You know what factories are like. There is a little bit of crackle on these records. However, there's not that much, and it's only heard during the intervals between songs, which is very common on records, as you'll know. It's not muddy at all, and it has very good clarity throughout. It seems to me that the drums are quite a bit lower in the mix compared to the remastered version, and that the vocals and guitars really take the precedent in this mix, which is preferred for me. So one of the things you'll notice immediately if you've seen other pressings of this record is that the aspect ratio with the green bars at the top and bottom are no longer on this. So this looks just like the original pressing, which is fitting because it isn't remastered. It is the original mix as it was intended. And I also think it just looks better without the green bars on it. All of the artwork was photography that was taken by George Petit, who is the vocalist for the band. So as we flip this over, there is actually a difference between this and the original pressing. On the original pressing, there is a shot where you can see the knife in the foreground and then the girls are in some kind of wrestling grapple. For whatever reason, they have decided they have replaced this shot with a chain link fence with one of the hands on it. I don't mind the change, however, and I think that this replacement is done in good taste. You will have noticed the hype sticker on the front, and I am pleased to say that this is not attached to the front cover of the record, and it is only on the plastic cover. For that reason, I keep the plastic cover, because I do like the look of the sticker, and I think it's part of the package. I'm under the impression that on the original release there was no inner sleeve with artwork and that it was a plain white inner sleeve. So this is all new. The reason for this type of artwork for this album is because the band's music had been described as, and I'm paraphrasing here so it's not a direct quote, but it's something along the lines of two Catholic schoolgirls fighting on a playground. The band members enjoyed that review and they rolled with it. It's halfway to the Led Zeppelin story. On the other side of the inner sleeve is the album's names of the songs and lyrics and credits, of course. Good quality all around. As we pull out the record out of the sleeve, you can see how vibrant the blue is on this. It has to be said, it's one of the most beautiful blue records I've seen. You'll notice the Nagaoka anti-static sleeve. And that's something that I put around all of my records that have artwork with their inner sleeve, as I feel it gives an extra layer of protection from static and potential scratches as well. Highly recommend them. The labels on this pressing also seem unique to it, as they don't match any of the other pressings that I've seen also. It's worth noting that the previous reissues were spread across two discs, and this is only one disc. And it has to be said that I prefer it that way. If it's not entirely necessary, and sometimes it is because you can hear inner groove distortion when there's too many tracks on one disc, but there's none of that on this. So that's another point for this pressing. So, to recap, this is great, fantastic, and if you like this record, then you should get this version. No question about it.